Hello folks, welcome back. In today's video, I will show you how to set up a workflow approval process with multiple reminders using Power Automate. So stay tuned and let's go to the demo after this short intro. One way to set up reminder emails in Power Automate workflows is to create a parallel process next to the approval process. Then we add some delay, and at the end of the delay period, check if workflow approval process is not completed, then send a reminder email. But there are a couple of drawbacks of using this process. First, the workflow will wait for the delay period even when the approval is complete. So the workflow process will run for longer than required. Secondly, the reminder email will only contain the message like, you have not action on the last approval email. The email itself cannot contain the approval adaptive card to action. This can leave approver person in a place where they must search for the original approval email and perform action on it. Alternatively, we can use do until control and set the approval action to expire, for example, 7 days expiry on the approval process. Once expired, we can restart the same approval process for n number of times. Let's see in action how we can achieve this process via Power Automate workflows. I'm in Office 365. From the left-hand menu, you can see the Power Automate application icon. If you don't see it here, click on the three ellipses and then go to all apps, and then if I scroll down, I will see the Power Automate application icon listed here. So if I click on it, this will take me to the Microsoft Power Automation homepage. If I click on create from the left menu, and I want it to be created in automated flow, so when an item is created, for example, in Microsoft list, then it should initiate this approval process. So click on automated flow. I'm just calling this flow approval with reminders, and the trigger will be when an item is created in a SharePoint list or Microsoft list in my case. I'll click on create. Now the first step is I need to connect this to a list. I have a contact list here which is sitting on this campaign management site. So if I just copy the link from here, and if I go here and enter a custom value, select the site, and then I can select contact list here. So that's the list I want to run the workflow when a new contact get added goes for an approval. Okay, and the next step is I want to initialize two variables here. One variable will be a boolean type which we can use in the do until loop to check either the person have action on the approval process or not. And the second variable I'm going to create is going to be an integer to just check how many times we need to run this reminder email, and we can increment the integer by value of 1 every time a new reminder email gets sent. So I will initialize those variables. Click on next step. I will select initialize variable. So the first variable, let me just rename it. So just renaming the header, then I will call it action type boolean, and the default value of this one is, I will set it to go to expression and then type false. Select false and say okay. So it's not been actioned yet, so the approval process not been actioned yet, so I'm just keeping it false. And the next variable, I'm going to initialize another variable. This will be an integer variable. Let me just rename the header. I will just call it reminder counter, and then I'll make this as integer, and the value of this one will start from 0. Okay, now the next step I need to do is I need to create a do until condition here. If I click on next step, and I need to select do until control. Now I need to say that if the action value is equal to true, until unless the action value is equal to true, just keep looping through this. So I've selected the action variable, but you can see this is grayed out. For some reason I need to go to advanced mode, click here and then go to basic mode, and then this value is available to select. So I will say equal to, choose a value. If I go to expression, I will select true here and select okay. So now what I'm saying is that if the action is equal to true, which means that unless the approval process is completed by that person, repeat this loop. Whatever actions are in this loop, repeat them. The next thing we need to do is we need to start an approval process. So if I click on next step here, so I will select start and wait for an approval. So the approval type, I will just keep it first to respond, just keep it simple. And the title, I'll just call it contact approval assigned to. For this demo purpose, I will just assign this to myself, and the link to item, I will just put link to item, I will select that, and the description, I will just select the title of that contact, or maybe I will select the first name, base, last name, for example. Okay, so that approval process is started. One mistake I did is that I've started this approval process outside this do until loop. I should be selecting this one, but never mind. You can just drag this one and drop inside the do until loop. So until this condition is true, repeat this step. And now the next thing we need to do is we need to set this counter, because we have started once the already approval process, so we can set the counter to 1. But before that, we need to set the timeout value for this approval process. So let's say, for example, if someone did not respond to this in, let's say, 7 days, we want to send another reminder. So you go to these three ellipses and click on settings. And then in the duration, if I click on this icon here, it's saying specify duration in ISO 8601 format. By default, you can see the example is P1D, which means that it will timeout after 1 day. So for this testing purpose, rather than doing P7D, which will be 7 days, I will say PT2M, which means that it's gonna be 2 minutes. And then every 2 minutes, it will send another reminder email. So I will click on that, done. So we have done this step. Next step is we need to increase this reminder counter variable by 1. So if I click on add an action inside this do until loop, we can increment variable. So if I click on increment variable, because it's an integer variable, we can increment the value. From the drop down, I will select reminder counter. We increment the value by 1. In the increment variable, I want to make sure this action config rule are set properly. So it should run after the successful of approval, or also if the approval has timed out. So if I select them both and click on done. Next thing is I want to add a condition. So the condition control I will select, and I need to check two values. The first value is approval outcome is not equal to null. So either is approve or reject, but not null. In that case, that we know that if it's null, then the approval haven't replied to the first email, hence we're sending the reminder. And we also need to check another condition, which is add row. And instead of and, I will check all conditions. So either one of them is true, we can go into this section. And the second condition is if the reminder counter is equal to, for example, if you want to send one email and then two reminders, we can set this equal to 3, because after sending the first email, we are setting the variable, incrementing it by 1, and then it will be further 2 reminders, and then after that, it will come into this condition. So here we need to set the variable, action variable, to true, so we can come out of this do until loop. So the set variable action is equal to expression, and I will type true, select true. So we'll setting the value true, so we can come out of this do until loop in either condition. If outcome is not null, which means that the approval have replied to the first email or the reminder email, or the reminder actually exceed the number of values of 3, which means that we only sending first email and 2 reminders and we wishing to come out. You can enhance this workflow by adding other scenarios, like if the approval outcome is approved, then do this. If reject, then do this. And if is if after 3 tries person does not approve it, then send email to the person that will try to reach you 3 times for this contact approval, but we haven't received any reply, so we are just terminating this workflow. So for testing purpose, this is enough, I think. I will click on save. Now I will go back to contact list and create a new contact. I've just created a new dummy contact here. I will click on save. This should initiate the workflow process. Now we can see the workflow is started, it's running, and I have received the first email, contact approval email. I have set 2 minutes timeout for the approval process, so I'm expecting another reminder email after 2 minutes. So I want action on this first email. I will actually action on the reminder email. I will pause this video for now and I will resume it after I receive the reminder email. Now I've received another email. This is exactly after 2 minutes of the first email. So this time I can go and approve this workflow process. Before I do that, I will show you on the workflow history that is in the do until loop, and it's just looping through it until unless someone approve it or it send the max number of reminders. So I will click on submit. So I'm approving this time. If I go back to the workflow, now you can see that the workflow is completed. So it came in first time, send approval, increment the variable by one, and then the approval ran out and it checked the condition. So the condition did not met, so it did not set the action variable to true. And then if I go to next do until section, it sent the reminder email, so it initiated the same process again, and it increment the value by one, so the value is two now. But this time I have replied to this reminder email and approved this process, hence it set the action variable to true and the workflow come out of the do until loop. So just to wrap up this video, today you have learned how to set up a workflow approval process on Microsoft List with multiple reminders using Power Automate. Thank you very much for watching this video. Consider subscribing if you're new to the channel by pressing the red subscribe button below this video and click the notification bell icon so you don't miss any of my future videos as I upload new videos every week. Give this video a thumbs up if you found it useful. If you have any questions regarding this topic or any other query related to Office 365, post in the comment section below. I review my comments on a daily basis. I will be happy to answer. Thank you.